House sitter hears something in the bathroom and immediately calls the cops. Two men from Oregon had agreed to house sit for their nephew, but they had no idea that their day was about to turn into a total nightmare. As house sitters, they were responsible for ensuring that nothing went wrong in the house until their nephew returned, but they soon realized that they weren't home alone. The men had agreed to watch the house while their nephew was gone. It wasn't really that difficult, as they didn't have much to do except keep the dog happy and make sure no one broke in. Other than that, it was like a mini staycation, or so they thought. The men decided to go walk the dog, but when they came back, they heard something ominous coming from the bathroom. It sounded like a thump, followed by several thumps. They thought someone had broken in while they were away, but unbeknownst to them, the intruder had been in there the entire time. The men cautiously approached the bathroom and tried opening the door, but it was sealed shut. They assumed whoever was in there had probably barricaded themselves in to avoid being captured. The men feared for their lives, and so they called for help. On April 9th, the two scared men dialed 911 at 1:48 p.m. They reported that a burglar had broken into the home in Cedar Hills neighborhood outside Beaverton, Oregon, which was about 7 miles west of downtown Portland. The caller claimed he could see something alarming. The man reported that he saw the intruder's shadow moving under the door. Fortunately, a detective was in the neighborhood and rushed over to the house. But when he got there, he realized he needed plenty of backup to deal with this menace. Now they needed to find out if there was just one burglar or if there could potentially be more. The detective met the three other deputies from the sheriff's office and two canine officers from Beaverton's police force. They all took a deep breath and prepared to confront the intruder, but they knew full well that they were putting their lives on the line. They announced their presence and warned the intruder that it was over and that they had to surrender, but the intruder didn't move a muscle. This forced the officers to unleash the police dogs, but this didn't seem to ruffle the intruder's feathers either. According to Ashland Tidings, Deputy Brian Rogers heard rustling in the bathroom when they came into the house, so he and his fellow officers surrounded the bathroom and prepared for the ultimate battle. Whoever was inside the bathroom had refused to come out with their hands up, but they were making an awful lot of noise in there, and the officers feared that they were looking for a way to escape, but they wouldn't get the chance. In an interview with the Washington Post, Sergeant Danny DiPietro, a spokesperson for the Washington County Sheriff's Office, said, 100% they had their guns out and the dogs out. If we tell you we're the police and you're not responding and not coming out, we don't know what we're walking into. We don't know if they're armed or if they're going to attack us. But they had no idea what they'd end up coming face to face with on the other side of the door. DiPietro told NPR that the responding officers were really puzzled by the intruder's lack of response. That was confusing because usually when we say, we've got a dog, people are like, okay, I'm not fighting a dog, and they just give up. But there was more happening on the other side of the door than the officers realized, and soon enough it would turn into a pretty ridiculous situation. The officers were completely unaware that something in the house was going about its programmed duties. It emitted a soft rumbling sound, but they had no idea they were about to encounter a new threat to law enforcement. At 2:05 p.m., less than an hour since the initial 911 call was made, the officers opened the door to confront the intruder, but they quickly learned that it wasn't much of a burglar at all, or even human for that matter. So what was it? It was just this little round machine slamming against the glass shower wall, DiPietro told NPR. It turns out the intruder was nothing more than a Roomba robot vacuum that was doing its job a little too well. But the officers were the total opposite of upset. We breached the bathroom door and encountered a very thorough vacuuming job being done by a Roomba robotic vacuum cleaner, Deputy Rogers wrote on the department's Facebook page. But it wasn't bullets that erupted afterwards. Everyone just started cracking up. It was such a huge relief because it's the kind of situation that could go either way, DiPietro told NPR. No one had any idea what was waiting for them behind the door, but they definitely didn't expect that. But would the caller face charges for their mistake? The responding officers had convinced themselves that there was an intruder on the other side of the bathroom door, just like the house sitters did, so they didn't really blame the man who made the call, not that this helped alleviate his guilt. The man felt awful about making the call, according to DiPietro, who added, I would have done the exact same thing if I was visiting someone and didn't know there was a robot vacuum cleaner that was set to go off on its own. The two men who were house-sitting had no idea that their nephew even owned a Roomba, But in all fairness, the officers were just as convinced that there was an intruder on the other side as much as they were. And the officers weren't the only ones laughing. The officers recounted everything that happened on their Facebook page under a fake Most Wanted poster, which showed a photo of the Roomba. And soon, hundreds of netizens jumped in to have a good laugh at the caller's expense. I find it amazing that the vacuum decided to barricade himself in such a standoff. Tech is taking over. A man named Fred Caused wrote on the post. Another commenter named Richard Cox wrote, "After sweeping the premises, the perpetrator was nabbed. Later, the room was dusted for prints." But they all agreed on one thing. Although the intruder was nothing more than a Roomba robot, everyone was grateful that the officers took the call seriously and proved to people that these brave officers take their jobs seriously to ensure everyone is safe. The officers were in no danger because the Roomba wasn't exactly a T-800 Terminator, but it definitely made for the most hilarious body camera footage that cops have ever released, and everyone is still having a good laugh over the whole thing.